Unlike any other in the long course of American history, a terrorist act of war against this country.
The enemy struck America on September 11th. But who is the enemy?
Bin Laden.
This is his M.O.
We have to look to the Middle East. We have to look to Osama bin Laden.
Fabled Enemies is the first 9/11 film to take a close look at the terrorist ties to intelligence networks inside the United States.
Some U.S. investigators believe that there are Israelis again very much engaged in spying in and on the U.S.
I'm aware that some Israeli citizens have been detained.
Bin Laden's connections to the CIA, the hijackers' ties to the FBI, the Saudi Arabian connection, the Israeli intelligence network, warnings and war games, the shadow government, and much, much more. Fabled Enemies. Get the DVD at Infowars.com or see it in super high quality, along with hundreds of other titles at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Either you are with us or you are with the terrorists.
Do you have aches and pains or suffer from indigestion or inflammation? Are you tired of feeling restless from insomnia? These symptoms are produced by negative toxins, but with the correct information, understanding, and care, you can cleanse them from your body. AloeMaster.com would like to help you begin the road to recovery with aloe vera. For over 4,000 years, aloe vera has been known for its therapeutic and healing properties and is widely recognized as the plant that helps alleviate minor burns. AloeMaster.com picks the best aloe leaves and produces the most potent aloe vera concentrated juices and freeze-dried capsules you can find. AloeMaster.com offers products with 10 times the potency of ordinary aloe products, enhancing the benefits of this ancient cleansing plant. Turn over a new leaf and visit us today at AloeMaster.com. That's AloeMaster.com or call us at 1-800-934-ALOE. That's 1-800-934-2563 today.
All right, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to play the rest of his speech and then come back. I'm going to write some notes and I'll comment on the points he made here in the last few minutes. Back to Barack Obama.
To find meaning in something greater than themselves.
I'm sorry, I can't help it. Again, he said it 50 times if he didn't say it 100. Find meaning in themselves through the group collective. Giving into service to be part of the group collective to find meaning in themselves. They take your soul. The New World Order dumbs you down, breaks you down, destroys the economy, and then says, come to us. We will remake you. Classic brainwashing. Classic cult programming.
And yet, at this moment, a moment that will define a generation, it is precisely this spirit that must inhabit us all.
A spirit must inhabit us all. So he's invoking a new religion of worshiping government, bringing in the New World Order, the New Age, that he already said three times.
For as much as government can do and must do, it is ultimately the faith and determination of the American people upon...
See, this is a twisting. He says we're individualistic, but we got to have a big government. He then says we're all in this together collectively. He then says, but government can't do it all, you've got to do it, which is a true message, but that means the people getting behind the evil and being suckered into accepting it. I mean, this is so twisted.
Which this nation relies. It is the kindness to take in a stranger when the levees break. The selflessness.
See, just like they start all this with soup kitchens and helping build levees, all sounds reasonable, but really it's secret police, tattletale squads, environmental squads.
Of workers who would rather cut their hours than see a friend lose their job, which sees us through our darkest hours. It is the firefighter's courage.
See, cut your hours. Don't make as much money. Now, that has nothing to do with doing it for a coworker. People are going to lose their jobs. It's going to get worse because of what his banker masters have done. The New World Order engineers, the architects. But he's making that a beautiful thing. You did it for America. You lost your job. You trained that foreigner that's replacing you. For America. You did it.
To storm a stairway filled with smoke, but also a parent's will.
See, then he mixed giving up your job with being a firefighter. Everybody's for saving children. Firefighters are incredibly brave. We love them. But he's with their reflected glory, just like Bush on top of the pile with a bullhorn, it made him the hero. You see? Same sick thing.
Bring this to nurture a child that finally decides our fate. Our challenge.
See, now, firemen, you know, helping children, doing all of that.
...may be new. The instruments with which we meet them may be new. But those values upon which our success...
See, he's saying American values, what we are, but we're doing something new.
Depends. Honesty and hard work, courage and fair...
All the criminals you've got running your administration. So he's saying government's there to take all your tax money and give it to offshore banks, and then you're going to get nothing and then volunteer forcibly like slaves in the Soviet Union.
Play tolerance and curiosity, loyalty and patriotism. These things are old. These things are true. They have been the quiet force of progress throughout our history. What is demanded then is a return to these troops.
So he's saying we're going to do something new, but it's really the old. It's patriotism. It's dead soldiers. It's firefighters. Now, let the bankers take over. We're going to use NORTHCOM against you.
What is required of us now is a new era of responsibility, a recognition on the part of every American that we have duties to ourselves, our nation, and the world.
They're getting you ready for a regular army draft, a 1 million-person domestic security force, and then separate Obama's own private army running in government PSAs everywhere, usaservice.org. Private army under his control, government armies, and what? You're not for service? You're the ones holding back us fixing this country. You're the one. You've caused all this. We're going to come back and finish up with this, and then at the 8 after, we're going to have guests in studio. Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com are the websites.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Hello, friends. This is Alex Jones. I've told you for a long time it's important to be self-sufficient, and today that's more important than ever. We need to be independent, and food and water is the key. You'll never have to stand in a bread line if you have your own bread. You'll never have to go to the Superdome and beg for FEMA to take care of your family in any emergency if you simply prepare. No one is going to take care of your family in the final equation but you. You know eFoodsDirect.com is still able to ship storable food that's safe from E. coli, salmonella, genetic alteration, or Chinese imports. And they do it at almost half the cost of last year's grocery prices. Call 1-800-409-5633 or on the web, go to eFoodsDirect.com. Visit eFoodsDirect.com and look over the fine list of high-quality, freeze-dried, and dehydrated foods they have to offer. Watch the free videos, look at their online catalog, or give them a call at 1-800-409-5633. Again, 800-409-5633 or on the web at eFoodsDirect.com. Take action today. The first step is getting storable food.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have Barry Cooper, Never Get Busted filmmaker, in studio coming up with us at the 8 after. We may even do some overdrive today so we have time to take some of your phone calls. But I need to finish up here with Barack Obama and his the most deceptive, manipulative, scientifically crafted speech I have ever seen that was written by the technocrats, the psych warfare experts, for him. So here it is.
Duties that we do not grudgingly accept, but rather seize gladly. Firm.
Remember what Aldous Huxley said about how people can be made to love their servitude? In fact, come in with that audio and with Walter Cronkite talking about world government and how great it is. Come in with that. When we come back in the next segment, we're going to play that little piece with Aldous Huxley saying people can be made to love their servitude and slavery. See, oh, you don't grudgingly become a slave of the government and not just pay taxes to save America from the bankers that have engineered this, but you love it. You love your slavery. And then the people that are all drinking the Kool-Aid, they're going to say it's our fault. He already said that in the speech. If we don't do everything he says, it's our fault things are going to get bad. He's our dear leader, Mao Zedong, Barack Obama.
In the knowledge that there is nothing so satisfying to the spirit, so defining of our character, than giving our all to a difficult task.
That's right. Truly fighting the New World Order. Truly fighting the police state. Truly fighting the corrupt police who've been caught all over the nation thousands of times per state. In Houston, 4,000 times plus, Houston Chronicle, setting people up who are innocent, planting drugs on them. You know, things like that we're going to be talking about coming up. You know, not being told you're patriotic and a great hero because the media and the culture tell you because you serve their New World Order, but actually being real heroes and fighting you and the people that control you and George Bush and the rest of them.
This is the price and the promise of citizenship.
This is the promise and the price. I thought I was born an American free with the Bill of Rights Constitution. No, I got to work as a slave.